welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Macy and my husband and I just bought a house, but today I actually want to take you on a little home tour of our current space because we've really, really loved living here. We lived here for about 8 months. It's a 3-bed, 1.5 bath, so we're definitely gonna miss this space. I feel like it's the first space that we've really felt like has really kind of felt more like home and being able to put a lot of more personal touches, but obviously we are excited about our new house. So I kind of want to take you through, show you some of my favorite things and some of the items that will be coming with us. So without further ado, let's just get straight into it. Okay, so let's start over here. I love this couch when we first purchased it a couple years ago, but at this point, it's not the most comfortable couch. The color, I feel like, and the style is just not really what I want in our new space, and I would say like what my style is now. So unfortunately, it probably will be coming with us until we can find a replacement. Up here is this piece of artwork that my mom and I actually did. So it'll definitely be coming with us in the new house, although I'm not quite sure where I want to put it yet. I kind of want to do things a little differently in this new space, so I don't think it'll be in the living room, but of course, again, it's coming with us. And then over here, we have this marble coffee table. I love this table. I got it off of Facebook Marketplace, and it's just very classic. And then this rug, which I definitely will link if I can, is from Crate & Barrel. It's just a classic Cecil rug. It's just really great. It's got great texture to it, and I feel like it works in a ton of different spaces. And then over here, we kind of have this really cool brick feature wall. It's not functional, as you can see, as a fireplace, but I actually put some candles under here that originally are from our wedding reception. I thought that was kind of a cool touch. And then over here, these are vintage. So I found these actually thanks to one of my sister-in-laws, Lindsay. Thank you, Lindsay. They're really cool. They just have like really interesting detail to them. They definitely have some wear, but I honestly think that adds to the character. So these, of course, again, will definitely be going in the new home. And over here is one of my favorite furniture pieces that we own. And it is this beautiful credenza. It's originally from Crate & Barrel, but of course I got it off of Facebook Marketplace. And it was actually this like very red kind of cherry wood tone, which not my favorite. So my mom and I painted it in this really gorgeous black chalk paint, and then we just waxed on top because it is like a high trafficked area, so we wanted to make sure we were protecting it, and I love the way it turned out. So yeah, I love the texture here. It's great because it does open, since we do not have like any type of closet here, and we actually don't in the new house as well. It's just really nice having like the option to put shoes here. This is also not yogurt. This is actually salt for when it's like super cold and icy and wet outside. And then I also ended up painting these with Rub and Buff. So these were just originally silver legs and I went ahead and switched them up. Rub and Buff is amazing. I will link the color and the one that I used below. So coming over here, we have this basket. I love this basket. It's just this kind of like textured woven piece. Again, I think it's so great in so many different spaces, even though I would say it kind of leans a little bit more boho, which I would not describe my style as. I think it's great because it adds like texture to the space. And yeah, this is one of the first things that we actually purchased when we got married. We used our Crate & Barrel gift cards and bought this, and I love it. So if I can find it online, I definitely will link it. Okay, now let's head into the dining room space, which out of all the spaces in our home, this is definitely my favorite. It's just, I don't know, I feel like it was the one space that really came together. Like, there's nothing that needs to be finished in this space. And so yeah, I love it. It also has some really cool, unique pieces in it. So let's start over here. So first of all, this mirror. At first, I wasn't quite sure if I should get it. It was only $19.99. And I kept looking at it and I was like, no, I have to go back and get it. Cause at the time I had no idea where I was gonna put it, but I'm obviously glad I bought it. And it looks so perfect here. I already have kind of some ideas of where I wanna put it in the new house, but it just, yeah, it's one of my favorite pieces. It's got beautiful detailing. And over here, we just have these frames that I got from Michaels. It's just a set. And I actually ended up putting these really cool old vintage pages in them from this book that I thrifted quite a while ago. So then over here, we've just got just books that we have. These bookends actually were also thrifted as well, and I love them. They just have really cool detailing. And then this little like basin urn thing, this also was thrifted, and I just kind of put some fake moss from Michael's, very like restoration hardware vibes, love that. And then we have to talk about this, because this again is one of my favorite pieces. So I've been looking for a bust for so long. I was willing to travel to Michigan, like I was willing to do whatever it took to get the bust that I wanted. And I just was having no luck. I had looked for like at least a month. And then this one randomly popped up on my Facebook Marketplace like notifications. It had already been posted for a week, so I immediately reached out, and I mean, I love it. I actually ended up buying this like pedestal from them as well. So I originally thought I was gonna paint it, and I love the way that it looked in this space, but now thinking about moving and how our new space is, I might actually paint it. So we'll see, I'm not sure yet. Same with her, I kind of like that she's a little aged looking, but I do also like the clean, crisp look of a bust, so. We'll see, not quite sure yet. And then let's go over this like credenza piece here. So this is again, another Facebook Marketplace find. This was such a great piece because I actually got it completely brand new. The woman who sold it to me was actually a stager. So she just was like, we used it for a home, didn't need it. So I got it, and it has like all the original kind of like paperwork. And it's great because it's super like shallow. So it's not really deep. It wasn't gonna take too much up of this space. And it actually has brackets that you can like hook into the back, which is great. So you don't have to worry about it tipping over at any point. And then over here, we have this really cool, gorgeous vase. Again, another Facebook Marketplace find, and another very heavy, sturdy piece. I've got like a few going on here. And I just really actually like the color. I like that it looks aged, and I don't know, it just kind of reminds me. I mean, of course, it reminds me of Europe, so that's why I love it. And then over here, we actually have our dinette area, which again, it's just, I think another reason too, I love this space is just being able to see all these pieces that I've purchased like secondhand or thrifting or whatever the case may be, and kind of seeing them all come together. So I love this table. I will be linking it if I can, if it's still available. It's originally from World Market, got it on Facebook Marketplace. But I just think it's such a beautiful piece. I love the warm tone marble on top. It's got like just beautiful veining, and then these chairs. So of course I wanted a set of all four matching, but it was really hard trying to find four that I really enjoyed secondhand. So I ended up just deciding to get pairs because I feel like I've seen that a lot more often now. It's becoming a lot more trendy. And then these salt and pepper shakers, which I actually did purchase secondhand as well. I got them back home when I lived in the DC area. And then this rug, I love this rug. It's very obviously like an oriental style. I'm not sure where it's originally from. I did get it on Facebook Marketplace, but I do just think it's such a beautiful piece in the sense of like, again, adding back in that color and texture, which is so important. Again, when you like neutrals, being able to add kind of back in more like earthy tones and natural tones without them just being black and white. I think that's kind of the hardest thing sometimes is finding that balance where things still feel very like comfortable and warm without feeling like too stark. Okay, and then coming over here, the like focal point I feel like of the dining room, especially when you first walk in and you see this space, is this gorgeous china cabinet that again, my mom and I ended up redoing. The interior is just a regular white interior paint. It's kind of a little bit off-white, so it's a softer, kind of creamier tone. So yeah, it's got these gorgeous shelves too and just really beautiful detailing. So I'm not quite sure if we wanna keep her in the dining room space or put her somewhere else in the home, in our new home, but I do really love it. And again, of course, it will be coming with us. So walking through the dining room, you walk into the kitchen. This is the door to the basement. It's unfinished. So this is a kitchen space. One thing though that I will say, even though overall this kitchen is amazing, it's got the high cabinets, again, it's huge, it is missing an island. And so when you're actually in here, it kind of feels a little awkward, just this kind of big space. So that's definitely one thing that like we were so excited about in the house, is that like we actually have a kitchen island now. But again, this kitchen has served us really, really well. I didn't really do a ton of decorating in this space just because, I don't know, I think spaces like this, especially when they're not your own personal style when it comes to like a lot of different things, like I would have done a different backsplash, I would have done the counters differently. I think it can just become really cluttered if you try and put a lot of small things in a space, even if it's a big space. But I did want to talk about our espresso maker because I love this thing so much. So it's really cool having like a little bar area over here. It's great. But yeah, this thing is incredible. If you've been looking for one or toying with the idea of getting this one from Breville, cannot recommend it enough. We use it all the time. It was the one thing that Joshua was like very, very adamant about wanting to get with the gift cards and stuff like that that we got, because one of the places we registered at was Crate and Barrel, so that's where we purchased it from. And I'm so glad we did. It steams milk amazingly, so even if you're not super big into like coffee, espresso, or like cappuccinos, you know, different types of coffee drinks, if you like tea lattes, it's incredible. And then coming over here, you kind of got this like extra kind of weird space, but over here is kind of like this weird limbo space. So if this space was ours, like if we bought this space, we were gonna stay here longer, I think we definitely would have done some type of like almost like IKEA kind of pack system, probably a little bit nicer looking just because it would be exposed. So it just kind of houses a bunch of random things. I actually have a lot of like DIY stuff in here. So like my paintbrushes, my sander and stuff like that is in some of these drawers, which is great. And then we just kind of obviously keep some fruit over here. We love this basket. It's from Crate and Barrel. So again, if I can, I will link it. And then we just have the shoe rack, which I believe we ordered on Amazon. So we have a couple of these. And then over here is the half bath. So like I mentioned before, this is a 3-bed, 1.5 bath. And again, another space that I just kind of felt like I didn't want to put a ton of like work and energy into decorating, especially because I wasn't sure how long we were going to be here for. So just very minimal. I really only added these two photos, which I love these pieces of art. So they're originally, again, of course, thrifted. And I just, the fact that I found them in a set was really big, but I love the fact that they're just like line drawings, and I love the wood frames. And yeah, they actually are signed by the original artist, which I always think is awesome. Yeah, we've got some basic things here. I did actually want to mention the trash can in here because I'm particular about very certain things. And so one of the things I really don't like is when trash cans and bathrooms are just open. So I ended up ordering these on Amazon Prime and I love them. They're super easy. You literally just, so love that. Definitely will be linking that as well. But yeah, that's basically the first floor. So now let's go head on upstairs. So I'm not huge on plants. I like real plants. I'm not huge on fake plants, but I just honestly, I'm one of those people who just forgets to water their plants. But this ivy here has actually thrived in this space and I'm so proud of it. So I've had it for a couple years. When I got it, it was like this tiny little sprout and it's just gotten so big. I kind of have it curled up right now. Okay, and then coming up the stairs, also the floors are very creaky in this place because it is an older space. There's my husband's office. Joshua's office is right here. So I'm not gonna go into it just because he's working and privacy reasons. I will pop up an image of the listing photo of how it looks though. And then coming from the office, Joshua's office is the bathroom. So this is the only full bathroom in this house. That's another obviously huge reason why we're so excited to be moving. We do have multiple full bathrooms in our new house. So this space again, just kind of kept it pretty simple, pretty minimal. There's a lot of things about it that like we just couldn't change that I would obviously like want to. Like, don't love the paint color. It's not horrible by any means, but again, it's just not my personal style. And then from the bathroom, you walk down this decently long hallway and then you enter into our master bedroom. This bedroom, our master, and I don't know, it just feels so cozy and I love the way it turned out. A lot of these pieces are from where we lived before in the apartment. This is actually the first DIY art project that I did and I love the way it turned out. Our nightstands were a Facebook Marketplace find. I love them. I love the wood tones. These are definitely coming with us to the new house. These frames I actually got matching. I got them thrifting, and I mentioned before how I used that old page from that book that I got thrifted and framed them and put them downstairs. So these are actually also from that same book. That book also has like photographs and like art in that as well. So that's what that's from. And then I love this. I'm like claiming this because I don't really recall seeing it before I did it, but I love this. So what I ended up doing was we had custom like vow books made because we did have like handwritten vows. This frame is obviously like we can take them out if we need to. It's not like they're like professionally framed by any means, but I just love the idea, especially because we did get them custom. They have our wedding date and Roman numerals, and yeah, they're just beautiful. They've got this like gold kind of like embossing on them. I'll link the Etsy shop that I got them from down below. And then I don't know, bedding's kind of pretty classic and simple. I definitely want to do something a little different when it comes to at least the pillows in the new house. So definitely keeping a white comforter and everything like that. These pillows were actually from Target. I got them quite a bit ago, so I don't know if they still sell them, but I love them. I just love that they're big and fluffy. This blanket is from Anthropology. This was also on our wedding registry. Then over here is just Joshua's side of the bed. I've got this really cool thrifted vintage vase. It's heavy. I've got quite a few of these, so this is just one of them that's over here. And then over here, I actually really love this space, and if you have a small space, this kind of dresser is amazing. Originally from IKEA, but I got it off Facebook Marketplace for like half the price, which is amazing. But it's great, it's just really shallow so I can still open up this closet door. And then I just have this mirror from Target that I bought like forever ago that I just have. And then this I got thrifting, which I love. And then this acrylic kind of necklace holder I also got thrifting. I think I actually got that in the DC area, so that's kind of been with me for at least a couple years now. This I got thrifting and I like putting my rings in there. And then this marble tray is actually from Crate and Barrel. So I believe it is like marble food safe. It's actually supposed to be in a kitchen, but I loved it to house my glasses because I do have quite a few prescription glasses. And then yeah, there's kind of, again, like I wanted to kind of keep this space pretty minimal. We have this mirror from IKEA that, I mean, it's great because it's not super big, but I definitely do dream, of course, of having a really tall mirror. I have one in my office right now that I will show you after this. I also wanted to mention the bed frame that we have. So it is from Amazon and we love it. I want to say it was like $200 maybe, which is pretty crazy. Bed frames tend to be very, very expensive. It's really simple. It's black. It's minimal. But the best thing about it, it's like the best height. So if you have a smaller space, I cannot recommend it enough. We have actually storage. So we have bins from IKEA that they just make that you can put under your bed. So anyway, let's head on out. So once you come down the hallway and you hit this bedroom, which again, we've made our master, you come into this space, which is my office. So I did end up taking technically the biggest bedroom in this space as my office. I do really love the way it turned out. This was not here pretty recently, but I ended up just leaving it up because I actually decided that I wanted more of a shoot kind of studio space. So things will definitely be changing in the new house. My goal for that kind of office, what would be an office, is really to have a studio space. I've learned over the past like 2 years that I don't actually really enjoy working at a desk. So I'd much rather have more of like a creative space. And then I'm thinking if I don't want a desk in my studio kind of space, then I can just put a desk either in like the guest bedroom or something like that if I do ever want to work at a desk. So anyway, so let's continue on to showing this room. So over here, I've just got these IKEA racks. They're like $9.99, honestly. They're such a steal. They're great if you are looking to kind of be able to store more pieces and you don't have a big closet, which is definitely something I will not miss about this space. The closets in here are tiny. So these have just been really nice. I use this, this is all my personal stuff. And then this rack is always used for either my vintage business or reselling business. So I kind of like to keep things a little separate. As you can notice, I do not have a desk in this space. So I did have a desk, but I ended up selling it. So it was one that I bought off of Facebook Marketplace. I painted it, I had it for a bit, and then I just sold it because didn't really love the style anymore. I felt like I needed something different. And then it was great because I realized if I was gonna use this as a studio space, I didn't really wanna have a desk to clutter and have to move and deal with anyway. So this is just the chair from that though, and I did have a desk. This I will link too if you are interested. It's from Amazon, it's like $75. It's a great work like chair. And then moving on over here, I love this marble table. It's originally from World Market and I do believe it's still being sold, so I will link it. It's just got this beautiful base, very like Parisian style. I've seen it quite a few times in different homes. And again, it's just one of those things that I feel like kind of regardless of your style, it can really work and be a beautiful piece in your space. And then really quickly, I wanna go over this label printer because if you are a small business owner and you do not have a thermal label printer, it will change your life. It is one of the best investments you can make for your business. So then over here is this gorgeous, like white kind of cream velvet love seat. It was a Facebook Marketplace find. That was crazy when I got it because I just so happened like a morning checking just Facebook Marketplace, figured like why not? And I had saw that it was just listed. It was like 7:30 or 8. So I immediately messaged the seller. I was like, is this still available? Can I pick it up? So within like 30 minutes to an hour of initially seeing it, like I was on my way to pick it up because it just had so much interest. So I just love it. I love the size. It's super comfortable. It could maybe fit two. It's definitely more comfortable to fit one. So it's just, it's nice being able to sit here and kind of relax. I don't know if I'm gonna have it in specifically like my studio or office space in the new home, but I feel like we can find somewhere to put it that'll be really, really cool. So coming over here, minus these poles, which I know are not the best looking, excuse me, is this Hobet mirror. So I love this mirror. It's from IKEA. It's like $130. It's such a steal. It's huge, like it's massive. I've never seen a mirror this big for this price. It's again just so great. And I'm not a silver person, and it does come with like an aluminum kind of frame, so of course I used Rub and Buff and I did kind of the edges, and I just think it looks so nice. It's just one of those pieces too that like you would never know. I technically only paid like $135, and that includes the like Rub and Buff. So it's yeah, it's just a great piece to have, especially if you are someone who kind of wants a larger frame in your office, you don't want to spend a ton of money on a mirror, and you're okay with having something a little bit more simple. Of course, I love the like Restoration Hardware, the Anthropology, like all those really nice full-length gold gilded mirrors. But they're like $1,000. And so I'm really glad that I ended up not spending that money, especially here yet, to get a mirror like that. And then over here, I actually ended up getting this shelf system. This is also from IKEA. This was like 75 bucks. I obviously like half styled it. It's not at all styled to how I would actually want it to be, but it is pretty functional. These boxes are also from IKEA. This one has a lot of like my like hair straightener and my like blow dryer, hair blow drying brush and stuff like that. And this one has more, like material things, so like scissors and pencils, and like I have like contracts, like I have some kind of important documents in there as well that I kind of need to access easily. So this has just kind of been like more of a functional space. This I got thrifting. Again, I told you I have a lot of vessels and things, and this marble tray, which I absolutely love, but again, it's just kind of half styled at this point. And then I've got my tripods. I just kind of had this stuff out at this point. Just kind of feels like making this space more functional makes more sense than trying to make it the most aesthetic space, especially since of course we are moving. But I do want to talk about this bust really quick, this mannequin. I actually originally bought it for our wedding to house my wedding dress, because first of all, the place that we got married was a historic site, and so they didn't have anywhere that you could like hang something. But my dress was also like 40 pounds. So even if they did, I didn't want to risk potentially like breaking something or anything like that. So came up with the idea, and I had seen it before, to put my dress on like a mannequin, and I just loved the idea. It just feels very like Parisian boutique, and yeah, so that's originally why I bought it. And it was like 75 bucks on Amazon. They unfortunately don't sell it anymore. I did end up looking to see if they did, and they don't. But I love it. I love the wood. It's just really classic. But I actually use it like every day and all the time now when I sell stuff on like Poshmark. So you will constantly see clothes and stuff like that modeled on here if I don't have like a stock image, or if I'm not actually wearing the piece. So it's just really cool because it's something that now is super, super functional, and I didn't necessarily buy with that intention, but it does have a lot of sentimental value, which I think is really cool. I do have my closet here. So instead of having my personal closet in our bedroom, I actually have it in here because this closet is a little bit bigger since it's technically supposed to be the master. It's still very small. I also wanted to showcase this rug. So it is an 8x10 rug. I also got off of Facebook Marketplace for like $75, which is crazy. Rugs are super expensive. And I really just love the color and the texture to it. It's nice because it kind of merges gray and cream and stuff like that. So I just love the way that it kind of looks in this space. And I'm actually thinking about putting it in our master bedroom in the new house. So that concludes today's current house tour of what our space is like right now. I hope you enjoyed this video. We've really, really loved living here. It's been so fun really making this space our home. We also have a great relationship with our landlords. They actually live right next door since this is a duplex. So it's just been a really, really great situation and scenario, but of course we are so thrilled to be moving into our first ever home that we own. So if you love content like this, make sure you subscribe and hit that like button, because I will be uploading some really, really great home content for you to enjoy. So until next time, bye.